The Gerd begins his campaign to the Grand Billion capital, Barhara, to declare his innocence. His first obstacle is Santa Claus. During the march, he finds his dying father, who gives him the holy weapon, Tearfig. You notice how the game didn't break there? That's because the weapon is literally broken. During the assault on Santa's base, Elvis is titled by the aging Grand Billion King to be the regent until Elvis's heir comes of age. Sigurd forces Santa to fuck off to the tundra, but Sigurd tells Oife Wonka and Shanahan, the Prince of Isaac, to take his son to Isaac in case something bad happens to him. The defeat of Santa Claus causes panic among the troops of Colonel Klink. Elvis has a meeting with the leader of the Lopto sect, Manfroy Shekelstein, who insists on Elvis making an heir. Little does Elvis know, I actually eavesdropped on Manfroy and found out what's going on with the Lopto sect. You see, years ago, Elvis was born from Duke Victor and Sigyn. Victor, though, couldn't control his dick, and fucked any woman that went near him as if he was Wilt Chamberlain. Sigyn decided to have an affair with Prince Kurt Cobain in revenge. Victor hanged himself when he found out, and Sigyn, burying Kurt's child, left for Verdane. The Lopto sect discover that Sigyn is a descendant of the Dark Dragon's disciple, who was blessed, just like how the 12 heroes that defeated the Dark Dragon years ago were. They began a search for Sigyn, only to find out that she's been dead for years. But her daughter lives. They also found out that Elvis has Dark Dragon blood too. So they blackmailed him with this information. Afraid of persecution, he helps them do anything they desire. They then find the daughter, attack her credit score, brainwash her, give her amnesia, and then put those two together as if they're playing Fire Emblem Awakening, hoping that they will have a child, which will have enough dark blood to wield the Dark Dragon's ultimate weapon.
I can't believe this story you're telling me. It's macabre.
Quanisha and Ethanol are at the border of the desert, with their troops and their daughter, but not their luggage carrier. They begin crossing the desert to rendezvous with Sigurd, only for the Thracians to ambush them and kill them, except for their daughter, who is adopted by the Thracian king for his own plans of evil. Sigurd's army marches to the Grand Billion border, where the coalition forces of Colonel Klink and Elvis await. Klink advances, only for Elvis's army to pull a Seki Gahara and betray Klink. Sigurd charges into the morale-depleted Klink army and kills Colonel Klink. Sigurd learns from one of Elvis's officers that Elvis is going to clear his allegations of treason, and has a barbecue waiting at the capital. Sigurd is relieved, and talks to Elvis, wanting to apologize to the king personally for this ordeal. Elvis instead brands Sigurd and his army with treason and prepares his execution. Elvis, being the smug ginger that he is, shows Sigurd his wife, who is actually the hippie chick Sigurd married. Sigurd becomes heartbroken, and the hippie chick begins to recognize him, breaking her amnesiac spell. Elvis decides this is the best time to send her back and begin the execution. But how? Why did Elvis stab Sigurd, his friend, in the back for power? Who could have persuaded him?
No! They expect one of us in the wreckage, brother.
Have we started the fire?
Yes. The fire rises.
can be like they are.
Come on, baby.
Don't feel the reaper.
Baby, take my hand.
Don't feel the reaper.
We'll be able to fly.
Don't feel the reaper.
Baby, I'm your man.